I first met Anna, it was the first weekend of college, and she sat down right next to me in the cafeteria.
When I first met Will, I don't know, just like somebody that I thought maybe could be friends with, and turned out true, so that was cool.
I thought she was extremely fun, just like a fun, don't want to say loud, not it's not loud, but it's, she was warm, welcoming, loving, and you could tell how much she cared just from being with her for 2 minutes.
I mean, I think like the obvious thing that all of our friends would probably tell you is that like, he's a good listener and I'm a good, you know, talker.
She is the fun, talkative, outgoing to more my reserved introvertedness.
I think he definitely centers me and I bring him out of his shell a little bit.
I think we're kind of like a perfect yin and yang where we balance each other out. Excited to grow our family with cats at first, and then maybe some little humans too.
You know, we've never lived without roommates before, so I think married life will signify the first time that, like, you know, when you hear the door open and close, you know who it is, and it's your husband. You know, that's kind of what I'm excited about. I hope that in 20 years we can look at our vows and say, we didn't nail it, we didn't do this every moment of every day, but we both tried our best to make those happen.
My name is Tila Biblowitz, and I want to welcome Anna's and Will's family to the wedding. The rest of us are not related by blood, but we are related by an immense amount of love.
When I first met you, freshman year of college, I had no idea back then that the next 9 years would be the best years and the happiest years of my life.
Anna Foreman, from the moment I met you, in the bone at 18 years old. You have been the most important thing in my life.
Every up and down I've had and I've been through, you were there for me. You show me the kind of care that I wish everybody in the world could experience. And sometimes you see me with more empathy than I see myself.
Anna, you're the most caring, loving, empathetic person I've ever met. Even outside of our relationship, I have seen no limit to your empathy. You have a heart so willing to open up and feel and understand others. I vow to always recognize and encourage this in you.
I vow to be present, to always choose positivity over negativity. I vow to listen as much as I talk. It's a big one. I'm so proud of the beautiful life that we are creating together, and it is a privilege to know you and to be growing with you.
I vow to continue growing with you, and I vow to always prioritize us. I love you, Anna.
According to the Jewish law and the state of California, I declare you husband and wife. You may kiss.
I want to say a few things about Will and Anna. Anna is perhaps the sweetest, most lovable, and loving young lady that I know. Well, how does this happen? Is it just genetics? When she was young, she was about 5 or 6, she would come into our bedroom in the morning. Jennifer was not a great sleeper, so I would do anything I could to keep Jennifer able to sleep as long as possible. When Anna came in, I'd whisper, "Anna, Mommy is sleeping. Don't wake her up." Anna would look me right in the eye, take her little finger, and stick it in Jennifer's eye. So it's been wonderful to watch Anna grow into adulthood. I'm impressed by her kindness, her passion to save the world one solar panel at a time. I'm proud of the person you are, and I'm also so pleased that you found Will to keep growing with.
The groom and I go back a decade. We were roommates our first year of college. Will, Quinn, Dan, and I all lived in a 5x8 cell for an entire year. Quinn insisted on keeping the window open the entire time throughout the winter. Will and I had to huddle together for warmth. And trust me, when you sleep less than a foot from another person, you get to know them pretty well. This is the man who exuded the easygoing humor, the quiet intelligence, and the self-confidence that we all know and love. The man destined to be my best friend.
I've been best friends with Anna since we were about 8 years old. For 3 years before we solidified our best friend status, Anna tried incessantly for me to be her friend. And I was a total jerk. For some reason, at 5 years old, I had it in my head that I had enough friends already. She would come up to me in synagogue and ask if I wanted to color under the chairs. She threw pencils at me in attempts to get my attention in class. Yep. And she continued to ask for play dates. I feel so lucky that Anna was so insistent and perceptive to be able to see that we were destined to be friends. As sure as Anna was that we were going to be best friends, she was equally sure about Will from the moment they started dating.
When Will and Anna first started dating, I knew it was the real deal. In fact, our friend group was so confident at the time, we used to joke that whatever house Will and Anna eventually moved into, we would move in with them. At the time, Anna and Will were like, "Yeah, come on in." So I guess the big question is, when are we moving to Denver?
Will and Anna, you are a beautiful couple. You are beautiful not just on the outside, but also on the inside. And I wish you that you have children that give you as much joy and love that you have given us.
Them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces, stylin', wildin'. hallelujah. Girl sent you hallelujah. Girl sent you hallelujah. 'Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. 'Cause Uptown Funk.